Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Bringing you some fun on a Monday night. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Chris Webber, this is Kevin Harlan. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. It's a one-game reprieve at home for the Bucks. Here with their Milwaukee fans, and then back on the road. Guys, when you compare their performance last season to where they sit right now, not a whole lot different story. Not necessarily a big surprise either.
And I think for the Bucks, they had the kind of hot and cold start that we've kind of come to expect. Nothing that would indicate they're in for any kind of a breakout season.
This makes you wonder, will they continue to be inconsistent as the season progresses? At this point, they look like they're still finding out their identity as a team, which is why they have struggled.
And let's get a quick pregame update from David Aldridge, who had a chance to talk with head coach Jason Kidd.
Guys, he told me their primary focus of the pregame discussion was defense. He said they're dealing with a very sophisticated offense, and it's going to require an outstanding effort from his players at the defensive end to come out on top. Let's see if that's the effort they get. Guys?
Thanks so much, David. And Chris, still early in the season, is the pecking order of teams still up in the air, or is it starting for you to lock in?
Well, it starts to lock in for a couple of teams. Those teams that you see start off with those good records, 9-1, 10-2, those elite teams that you see on each coast that kind of have their own mission. For everyone else, it's a little bit different. The pecking order, the fighting now, the jockeying really starts to get into right now. So that first 20 games, you establish who you are, your identity, and then the next 20, you're fighting to continue to keep that identity or improve it. So don't worry about wins and losses. Those other teams are going to separate, but can you just stay in the middle of the pack and improve and hopefully make your move when the playoffs come?
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So on the floor for Washington, Morris and Gortat together down low. The deadly duo of Wall and Beal are in the backcourt, and it's Porter in at the three. And we watch Giannis out there. He just looked unstoppable, Greg, at times. The way he's able to attack the rim, the blend of size, speed, and length is just unparalleled in the NBA.
And it's the movement that throws you off with Giannis. One step, and he's gone from the three line to the rim. There isn't any way to stop someone that skilled who's that big.
Both free throws good from Antetokounmpo.
Antetokounmpo, just incredibly talented, a long, lanky, athletic powerhouse of a player.
Wall dishes to Beal. Pass to Morris. Outside, Wall. Morris a screen. Nice ball movement by Washington. Five on the clock. Morris with a screen on Middleton. Porter with it. Now guarded by Middleton. Porter, no luck. Middleton drives in. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
Well, that opening right there, that's just because the defense failed to rotate.
Now, here's Porter. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Toronto.
Don't forget his rebounding work, too. They couldn't contain him on the glass.
Porter can't get that one to fall.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Yeah, coming off of a good pick, you want to get that. When he gets the separation he needs, I know he would love to have that one back.
Antetokounmpo can't get it to go. Wizards have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game.
Well, one thing the Wizards have done a good job of is making use of the corner three. It's the most efficient shot in the game. Wizards make sure they have that as an option on a lot of their sets. A very shaky start for them. After four attempts, they're still trying to find a target.
Henson's shot is off.
Some very slack defending. Playing with fire to leave him that open beyond the arc. Oh, after falling short on their first four shots, they got one to go, and now they're 1-for-5 from the field.
The Bucks have gone 1-of-3 from the field to start this one so far. And if you look at the personnel of the Wizards, it makes sense that they get so much use out of the corner three.
Well, not just because they have good shooting team from distance, but they have John Wall that breaks down the defense, attracts other defenders, which leaves wide open players for jump shots.
And here's Wall. And Giannis Antetokounmpo made that last three-pointer. Kicks it to Morris. Six to shoot. Porter with it. Now guarded by Antetokounmpo. Fires from the line. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Porter's got five.
Oh, I like watching Porter fill it up from the mid-range, demonstrating a nice touch from the in-between area of the floor.
Antetokounmpo passes to Snell. Down it goes. Nice one there from Antetokounmpo. He's got seven.
Nice way to start the evening. His number's getting calls, and for good reason.
Well, yeah, he's a guy who can carry you for stretches, long stretches in this game. You want to get him involved early and often. You can't lay that pass in there any better.
The pass to Snell. Back to Antetokounmpo. Trying his luck deep. A shot off that time. Now Washington takes it the other way. This game against Milwaukee here, it's their first look at the Bucks.
And they usually came out on top when these two teams faced off last year. No surprise, they're the better team.
Now here's Beal. He had 27 points last game. To the paint, here's Gortat. The shot goes down and it gets this game back to even. Gortat's got his second bucket tonight.
Gortat uses his athleticism on these type of finishes. He gets it done even in the face of the defense.
Bucket is good, and it's 9 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
His touch has been terrific this quarter. Most of what he puts up is going down.
Porter in the corner, fires the three, and again, Washington with the triple.
When Porter first came into the league, he didn't have this shot. Now he's a knockdown perimeter shooter.
Down it goes. Nice one there from Antetokounmpo.
And that's the kind of move that will always pay off, even against tight defense like he was facing on that possession.
Giannis Antetokounmpo, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for Milwaukee. He comes away with 11 points in the quarter and is showing no signs of fatigue. We've got more in store for you right after this. And John Wall spoke prior to the game. He talked about the identity of the Wizards team.
Defensively, just being that gritty and grimy team that makes it tough for teams to score in the paint. I think we can be a very great team.
The Wizards not exactly the first team that you think of when it comes to gritty and grimy team defense, but maybe he's really got a point here in how tough the Washington defense can be.
And you don't get there without the defense. I'm especially impressed that Wall has that mindset.
Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Bucks, guys.
Well, already in the first period, they found ways to get this offense ramped up.
Oh, yeah, small lead so far, but it's building fast, and they better watch out.
So this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting the second. Frazier is out there with Satoransky. Then there's Oubre. Then it's Jody Meeks. And it's Mahimi in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Now here's Meeks. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. Wizards passing it around. Here's Mahimi. And it's Mahimi finishing it off.
Oh, an aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Milwaukee in the lead. Dellavedova kicks to Maker. Back to Dellavedova from beyond the arc. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast. And, of course, NBA players have all reached this pinnacle through dedication, through very hard work. Chris, can you talk about the hard work and effort that goes into playing and succeeding at this NBA level?
Well, if you're in high school or middle school, when your friends are at the movies, you're on the basketball court. When your friends are hanging out at the party, you're at the basketball court. When your friends and his family are on vacation, you're at the basketball court. I don't think many people understand the dedication. You know, for many guys, it's more than 4 hours a day in the gym. And a lot of that is just sitting in the gym, just smelling the gym. You know, of course you're going to work out. Of course you're going to shoot. But it's everything basketball. You know, on my wall, I had Dominique, Magic, Bird. I had all these guys, Isaiah. for cutout magazines, and I would put their pictures on my wall and work out and do push-ups looking at them. And I would know their moves. I would know everything. You know, I remember Kenny Smith after his dunk contest, he stood at the free throw line and threw the ball between his legs, threw it off the backboard and dunked. I went in the backyard in Detroit, shoveled the snow, and we worked on that dunk all night, freezing. I mean, you have to love it. So, you know, when you love something, my father taught me, it's not work. Oh. And so you got to start with the love, and then all the other work and dedication is just part of the journey.
I love the message, but, boy, I like that Kenny Smith story. That is a great, great story. Here's Sadoransky. Dishes it to Frazier. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now 1-for-2.
Look at this. I like this team basketball, keeping the ball moving until they find the right shot.
And Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game. They come into this one following the loss to the Mavericks.
You know, they're the visiting team. It's a loud arena, very distracting at times, but simply no excuse for missing a ton of free throws.
And did you notice how each miss fired up the crowd even more? It became a vicious cycle.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with right now. Giannis Antetokounmpo's checked in for Mirza Teletovic. Tony Snell comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Eric Bledsoe in for Matthew Dellavedova. The Bucks shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And 74% has been the mark for them on the season thus far. And one thing you notice with Giannis is just how much better this team is with him on the floor. What he brings on offense and defense is as huge as any player in our league.
Here's Wall. And that one hits back iron.
Not pretty. You've just got to shake off a miss like that.
And it's a combo.
And here we get a chance to check out the story on Giannis Antetokounmpo. The last 10 games, he has been on a heck of a run. Fourth in scoring, fourth in blocks, and he's an elite glass eater, a factor inside among the top 10 in rebounds per game.
And as you said, one of the NBA's most potent scorers, always up to the challenge. His top five ranking has him right there with the elite. First free throw is good. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
And that one's good by Porter.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Maker dishes to Snell. Oubre pulls it in.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Wall against Bledsoe. Goes up on the high post. Again, the miss by Wall.
Man, right play, wrong result on that one. Generally, you knock those down.
I like the decision making. I mean, that's a shot you want to keep taking.
The shot from 20 feet away, and he hits the jump shot. Wall's got his first bucket in this one.
Look, you better get right up in Wall's grill. If you're not, he's going to quickly pull it up.
And the first half comes to a close. We've got a close game going on here. Bucks ahead, leading by just one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Jason, a hard-fought first half. How do you assess the game so far?
We're going to need everybody. And the one thing we got to do is we can't settle. We got to keep attacking and get the ball in the paint.
Use that length to your advantage. Thanks, Jason. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Time to check out the first half of action. A competitive matchup for Milwaukee in the first quarter. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output for both teams. and they still find themselves in a good position at the half. Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks' first half?
Well, I think they're feeling the energy of this hometown crowd. Sometimes you get a little complacent and comfortable in your surroundings, but no, they fed off adrenaline in the first half.
And over to Shaq, your take on the Wizards.
Well, this is a close game. Every point matters. Right now, they're not getting to the line much. To win this kind of matchup, you got to be the aggressor. You got to be, you just got to be aggressive. Let's just see if they can ramp up their intensity, Ernie.
That's it for now as the second half's just about ready to go.
My side girl got a 5S.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Adetokounmpo in this game has been everywhere.
Yeah, he's really been catching the defense off guard so far here in this game, racking up a bunch of trips to the line.
Well, in a few times, he's done a good job of initiating contact, yet getting the foul called on the defender.
Game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now. Here is Bledsoe. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Chris Middleton is out there with Antetokounmpo. Then there's Tony Snell. Then it's John Henson. And it's Bledsoe in at the one. That's the group for Milwaukee right now. Wall with some nice defense. Washington trailing.
And when I watch Eric Bledsoe, I really feel like he's at his best when he's kind of prodding a defense. So hard to keep away from the rim. When he attacks, it just opens everything else up in his offensive game.
For three, Middleton buries it from three-point range. Middleton's got the first bucket of the third here for the Bucks. Wizards trail by four. Here's Wall. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And, Greg, as you said, the aggressiveness Bledsoe has going to the rim is a key for him to getting those open shots then on the perimeter.
And the team is at their best when he is in attack mode. Opens up lanes for cuts as you just can't keep him out of the paint. Knows when to drop off a pass after he beats his opponent as well for an easy score.
Now here's Bledsoe. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. That one, no good.
You expected him to drop the hammer there, but the D was just good enough to cause the miss.
Porter passes to Beal. The dish to Gortat. Passes to Wall. And Henson sends it back. Middleton against Porter. Wall with a block.
Wall, one of the things that's underrated is that he's an insane athlete. Right there, he's just showing what an incredible defender he is with these type of blocks.
And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
For Washington, they have shot two free throws, and they're 1-2 so far.
A lot of players who are the age of Gortat would have started to slow down a bit. He's bucking that trend and continues to produce well. A very steady presence for his team in the paint.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with right now. Mirza Teletovic comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Eric Bledsoe. And that's a foul called on Bradley Beal. That's foul number two for him. Gortat with the steal.
While he tried to make a pass through an opening that wasn't there, he needs to be more patient and allow space to open up so he can throw it down low. Oh, they got that one to fall, and they need to keep it up after missing the first three shots of the half.
Chris, with Gortat, as you mentioned, he's right up there in age, but he's still doing what he's done his whole career.
Yeah, and a lot of it has to do with just how efficient Gortat has been as a scorer his whole career. He knows exactly what he can do and can't do in the paint when he's facing up. He has a career field goal percentage that's around 55. And that's very strong numbers.
That's what we're talking about in terms of the activity level defensively. You got to protect the rim.
Well, that takes physical ability, good timing, those two things that he possesses.
Wizards have gone only 1-5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively. With some arc, and so the ball out of bounds. Henson touched it last. A different look for Milwaukee. Maker comes in for Henson. And Malcolm Brogdon subbed in for Matthew Dellavedova. And then for Washington, Kelly Oubre's checked in for Gortat. And it's Jody Meeks in for Frazier. Oubre kicks to center answer. Mahimi's shot is good. And the Wizards lead by two.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Antetokounmpo dishes to Teletovic. Maker passes to Antetokounmpo. Shoots over Beal. And that's good from Antetokounmpo on the assist by Maker. Antetokounmpo's got the game tied up here for the Bucks. And Beal kicks to center and score. Outside Beal. Now here's Oubre, covered by Teletovic. Five on the clock. Here's Sadoransky. The putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Mahimi's got the lead up to two now for the Wizards.
Just in a perfect position to grab that rebound and then get the putback.
From eight, here's Maker. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
You know, I love how he absorbs the foul and still had a chance to knock that one down.
This is his first chance at the line tonight. And the Bucks making a change here. Bledsoe's checked in. And then for Washington, Morris is checked in for Mahimi. Otto Porter Jr. comes in for Meeks. And John Wall subbed in for Sadoransky. Now here's Wall. And you know the points will always be there for him. He's averaging just a shade under 20 points a game right now. Beal can't get it to go. For Milwaukee, they've gone 2-7 from the field in the third. That leaves room for improvements here. Antetokounmpo dishes to Teletovic. A three, Bledsoe. The shot, no good. Tie game in Milwaukee. And don't go away, we'll be back momentarily. And now a sneak peek into the huddle with Coach Jason Kidd.
We've taken all jump shots. Drive and make a play for a teammate. Keep talking on the defensive end. Relax, breathe.
And a number of issues to cover there for Coach Jason Kidd, trying to keep his guys aware of how they can improve.
And first up, looking for more unselfish play. Work together and try to have some fun out on the floor.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. Fourth quarter on the court for the Wizards. The explosive backcourt is Wall and Beal at the one and two. Oubre out there with Morris, and it's Porter at the small forward position.
You know, I like Morris. He's a valuable contributor on both ends of the floor. Now, he's a sniper from deep, and he can definitely lock you up on D as well.
And he knocks down the first one. Well, you look at Markieff Morris, and you see a player, Greg, who is finally meeting his potential.
And you know what? Give credit to Morris, because he's fallen in line with the team and the staff here. I think he's always had the talent to be an impact player. It just took a structured situation for him to really flourish, and I think he's found a home here in Washington. Just a terrific all-around scoring effort from him. I mean, it's because of that that they're even in this game.
The Wizards shooting 41% for the game. And Wall kicks to Porter. He dishes it to Beal. Morris with the screen for Beal. Back to Porter. Morris a screen. Porter with it. Now guarded by Middleton. Stolen by Bledsoe. Antetokounmpo passes to Brogdon. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. And the Bucks lead by two. Now the Wizards with it. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. There's a screen. And Beal kicks to Porter. He feeds it to Morris. It's stolen by Maker. Here's Bledsoe. Basket is good, and he'll get a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Yeah, exceptional play there to take the bump and still get it to fall.
Gortat's checked in for Washington.
What's up?
And Bledsoe, no good on that one. Wizards trail by four. All with it, now guarded by Bledsoe. Porter kicks to Wall. Trying to break that ice-cold streak, and Wall with the slam.
Look at that. That's the exceptional leaping skills of Wall. When he's running to the cup, you know he's trying to ram it down.
The feed to Maker, back to Bledsoe. The Bucks working the ball around. Dodged in the pass to Antetokounmpo. They set the pick. It's stolen by Morris. And it's Wall in the corner. Trains the three-pointer.
Look how Wall just measured that shot. I love when he does that. When he has the room to shoot from deep, he doesn't hesitate.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Here's Middleton. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. Game winding down, and they just keep changing leads.
And guys, no separation yet, and I really don't think we're going to see any all the way down.
Wall. And Maker sends it back. Bledsoe catch to Brogdon. Back to Bledsoe. Banked in off the glass. And now it's a three-point Bucks lead.
And so far in the second half, this has been a different kind of game than what we saw early on.
Attention to detail. They've really turned the corner here. Completely different team compared to their play and their focus in the first half. But you got to love Gortat commanding the ball during a big possession. Outstanding and providing for the Niners.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. They're up by one. We've got 1:28 left in the fourth quarter. And now we get the chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And the way he's made his mark with his work inside, he's just been a slasher tonight. Always moving, getting to the basket at will, and just seemingly taking advantage of a D that was reluctant to get in his way.
Johnny Snell's checked in for the Bucks. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to listen in on what Jason Kidd was talking about with his players. He told them, hey, guys, this is a close game, but if we execute right here, I like our chances. There's no need for hero ball. Trust one another. Make the simple play. Kevin, back to you.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo. And you could feel the crowd react as one.
Guys, what a blast of energy that just sent through this entire building.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. From the stripe, rebounded by Maker. Bucks have gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth, going 6 for 7. Bledsoe with it. He's picked up by Wall. They get the rebound. Back to Bledsoe. Beal against Middleton. Snell kicks to Maker. Feeds it to Middleton. That three off the mark.
Now you need every basket you can get.
As well as stops on defense. They have to be on their toes.
Porter, no luck.
Not quite airtight defense right there, but his release was a little bit off on the jump.
Washington calls timeout. They trail by three. 20 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
You know, you'd love to be able to clear space and get that triple, but you can also do the two with a quick foul.
But these are some of the toughest decisions. I mean, a good argument can be made for either case.
three-pointer would be huge right now.
If they can get a relatively open look from the perimeter, I say take it.
And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
We've got 13 seconds left in the game. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Shooting for Milwaukee. Giannis Antetokounmpo. Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that gives them a four-point cushion. Second one is good. Hitting both at the line, and it's a five-point game.
Well, they can breathe easy now thanks to those free throws. They won't have to sweat this one out.
Washington calls timeout. They trail by five. 12 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What do you think, guys?
And they're going to have to score. Quick foul. Can't waste any time here.
Well, it's a lot to talk about in this huddle. They'll also have to decide who they'll want to foul.
Beal can't get it to go. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Shooting for Milwaukee. Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Good on the first, and that increases their lead to six. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 7-point game. On the wing, Porter. And again, Washington, no good. So it's Milwaukee picking up the win. It was a fantastic ball game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, I mean, they faced some challenges, but really held firm when they needed to. On both ends, just effective in terms of coming away with this win.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Eric Bledsoe. Eric, a strong performance tonight. What's been the difference?
We're getting out of transition, you know, trying to get defensive stops. And everybody's just playing their game.
And it showed tonight, Eric. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. See you next time.